In this video presentation, I am going to show you how to use the normal CDF function on the TI-83 calculator to determine probabilities. For the first example, we want to find the probability that Z is less than 0.75. So basically, we would like to know the area to the left of 0.75. In order to find the area, we need to access the normal CDF function on the calculator. And in order to do so, we're going to first press the second button and then press vars to access the distribution. Normal CDF is number 2. With normal CDF on the home screen, you then need to enter in a lower bound and an upper bound. In this case, the lower bound is negative infinity. And since you can't put negative infinity into the calculator, I'm simply going to use negative 10. Then I'm going to press the comma button and then enter the upper bound, which is 0.75. Press enter, and 0.7734 is the area to the left of 0.75. For the second example, we're going to find the probability that Z is greater than or equal to 2.33. Basically, we're trying to find the area to the right of 2.33. And again, in order to do that, we need to access the normal CDF function on the calculator. To do so, press the second key and then vars to access the distribution. Press number 2 for normal CDF. And once again, we need to enter in a lower bound as well as an upper bound. In this case, our upper bound is positive infinity, and since you can't place positive infinity into the calculator, we're just going to simply use positive 10. So my lower bound will be 2.33. Again, use the comma key, which is located above the number 7, and then enter in 10. And you can see the area to the right of 2.33 is 0.0099. For this last example, we want to find the area between negative 0.99 and 2.87. Again, in order to do that, we're going to use the normal CDF function on the calculator. For this one, we already know the upper bound and the lower bound because it's given to us in the problem. So the lower bound is negative 0.99 and the upper bound is 2.87. Thus, the area is 0.8369.